Hi everybody, another Friday rolls around and we're filming on the outside. Don't know how much longer, but things are starting to go over now. All the plants here are slipping past their best. Vermilion bells are past their best. Little bit of life left in the old geraniums. Some cyclamen waiting their turn to go in the ground. Anemisha, somewhat past its best. And a delphinium putting on a brave show. I spoke to the studio flower manager. I won't tell you what she said because I'd like to think this is a family show. But talking of abuse, quite a few of you were concerned last week when I was on last week's film. I was filming in Chepstow. I'd been asked to leave a construction site. And a lot of you were offended by that. Please don't worry about it. I shouldn't have been there anyway, I don't think. I was pushing my luck. I knew I was pushing my luck. And I did get some footage, so I'm not worried. But I have to say, in my defence, on the map, it looked like an ordinary access road. And there was a fence between that road and the actual where they were building the actual construction. So I thought it worth a punt. I think we got away with it. There you go. Film club. This week there is a Denver. Another Denver. I've had a Denver request. Don't turn down many of those. The Windsong. Windsong. So we'll get to there. Let's get to our matters arising, shall we? Right. Our going on the vlog, which was the Cheltenham film at the end of the last vlog. Vishengo said, even the shopping area, places I would normally avoid, looked inviting. However, I was particularly intrigued by the shop at 1108, which rejoiced under the name of Old Guy's Rule. Simon, the hairy golfer, did you see the Old Guy's Rule shop in town? I may have to do a shopping trip. Come on, guys, keep up, keep up. Lee Cliff thought I was on the posh side of the Shire. Yes, they do let me over there down again. Not very often. Michael from Poland. The pink panther in Cheltenham was lovely. Brought back many memories. That's what we hope on this channel. It's a memories channel. Peter said, we're battening down the hatches in Taiwan for a typhoon. It's because we're complaining about our summer. Crikey, they're battening down for a typhoon. Woo. On the other hand, he says, went on the high-speed train here last week. 300 kilometres an hour and a £4 fare. Grief. £4. James Weeks. Now, James looks after our virtual mascot, Sumac MacArthur. And James has had some adventures in his life. He says, hi Ron, I taught physics in Cheltenham and being somewhat handy, I used to work on some of my colleagues' homes at weekends. One of them wanted a bedroom floor sanded off. So off to Travis Perkins we went, rented a floor sander. Back at his house, things were going quite well with the giant belt sander when all of a sudden, one of the clamps holding the handle came loose and the bottom part took off at high speed across the floor and crashed into the wall at the side of the room. That's what I learned how to plaster. Oh dear. He says he misses England and thanks for reviving some memories. On the other hand, of course, James is a teacher over in Canada. And he's back into teaching now after the COVID nonsense. But Sumac MacArthur then, who is our mascot, says, James kept this week's video to himself until now. A bit cranky, now he gets up at 5:30. 5:30 to go teaching, gee whiz. Wow, amazing. Keep it up, James. So going back to last week's film at Chepstow, again, Lee Cliff says, nice day over in the Principality. Yes, somewhere else they didn't notice me sneaking into. Malcolm Richardson says, it's a splendid old town. Always lifts my spirits when I visit. Yeah. Michael from Poland again. A very nostalgic visit after some 47 years. One of my mum's favourite places. Ah, yes, memories. In the same vein, Peter Smith. I haven't visited Chepstow for over 40 years since I took my late mum on a nostalgic visit, so thanks for the chance to revisit. Yeah, you're welcome, guys. Yeah. All about memories, isn't it? Martin Laws, on the other hand, said, it's a shame you didn't get on the Severn Princess, which is, I think, is one of the old ferries which was parked up in the harbour there. You could have become Pirate Parky and sailed to Portishead to check out the progress of the Portishead rail line. Clearly you've never seen me on a boat. It's not my favourite mode of transport, I have to say. And then the hairy golfer, Simon again. Thank you for the views of Chepstow Castle. When we were kids, the school trip was either Burford Wildlife Park or Chepstow Castle. Simon then goes on to describe the joys of school trips. Oh dear, the skin knees, the curly sandwiches. Good old Simon. Well done. Andrew Merriman, our Andrew, in the amazing. The buildings at 1146 almost certainly belonged to Fairfield Engineering Company. They were rail connected from the goods yard via the turnout just to the west of the goods shed, shown at 1701. And he then goes on to detail all the bits and pieces to do with that railway. It's absolutely amazing. If you thought you knew Chepstow and its railway, wait till you read Andrew's bit. So if you go into the comments, turn up Andrew Merriman and away you go. Amazing, amazing. To finish off then, Richard Wakeley. A very interesting walk, he says, another to add to my bucket list. To which I replied, time to get working on that bucket list, Richard. Don't put it off or you'll never get started. To which Richard replied, I'll have to wait till I get back to the UK first. I might have missed that little bit. Oh well, okay. So, film club this week then is another John Denver. It's the Windsong. You can almost feel the wind in your... Well, no, okay. I think this could be an anthem for Jim Nichols. Jim flies kites. If you go and look at his channel, click on Jim Nichols in the comments. Go and look at some of the kites, some of the things he gets into the air. Amazing, absolutely amazing. So this could be your anthem, Jim, I reckon. The Windsong. Give that a shot and see how you get on with that. Next week, we'll be going to Blakeney, which is a small town, village, town, I guess, in the Forest of Dean, and we've managed to dig out an old branch line there, an old disused branch line, and much grovelling and running around in nettles and goodness knows what, managed to get a film out of it, which we'll put on for next week then. So, I'll see you down in Blakeney next Friday. Don't be late.
Wind is the whisper of our mother, the earth. The wind is the hand of our father, the sky. The wind watches over our struggles and pleasures. The wind is a goddess who first learned to fly.
This is where the Maria Assumpta foundered. It's a sailing ship, refitted in Neilson's in Gloucester. Came down here on her maiden voyage. Tried to be clever, going between Moule Island and this. Hit the rocks. The owner died, the captain survived. I don't think he's a captain anymore.
Cities and canyons, thunder mountains, roar of the sea. The wind is the taker and giver of mornings. The wind is the symbol of all that is free. So welcome the wind and the wisdom she offers. Follow her summons when she calls again. In your heart and your soul. lift up your voice then and sing with the wind. La 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 la.
Just taking five. Just coming up to Pentara now. Fish with the rumps there over there. Get you a quick look. Got those in shot. So now just a 5 minute break and then we'll start the big push. A little way to go yet. It's a lovely walk, lovely night.